I invite you to stand for our processional hymn number 66. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also
let us pray. Lord of all power and might, the author and giver of all good things, graft in our hearts the love of your name. Increase in us true religion. Nourish us with all goodness, and bring forth in us the fruits of good works through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we hear from the Word of God.
Our first lesson is a reading from the book of Proverbs, beginning with the 25th chapter and the 6th verse. Do not put yourself forward in the king's presence or stand in the place of the great, for it is better to be told, come up here, than to be put lower in the presence of a noble. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is Psalm 112. We will pray it in unison. Hallelujah. Happy are they who fear the Lord and have great delight in his commandments. Their descendants will be mighty in the land. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches will be in their house, and their righteousness will last forever. Light shines in the darkness for the upright. The righteous are merciful and full of compassion. It is good for them to be generous in lending and to manage their affairs with justice, for they will never be shaken. The righteous will be kept in everlasting remembrance. They will not be afraid of any evil rumors. Their heart is right. They put their trust in the Lord.
Their heart is
established and will not shrink until they see their desire upon their enemies. They have given freely to the poor, and their righteousness stands fast forever. They will hold on their honor. The wicked will see it and be angry. They will gnash their teeth and pine away. The desires of the wicked will perish. The Lord will be full of compassion and mercy, slow to anger and great to kindness. Our second reading is from the letter to the Hebrews, beginning with the 13th chapter and the 1st verse. Let mutual love continue. Do not neglect to show hospitality to strangers, for by doing that, some have entertained angels without knowing it. Remember those who are in prison, as though you were in prison with them. Those who are being tortured, as though you yourself were being tortured. Let marriage be held in honor by all, and let the marriage bed be kept undefiled, for God will judge fornicators and adulterers. Keep your lives free from the love of money, and be content with what you have, for he has said, I will never leave you or forsake you. So we can say with confidence, the Lord is my helper, I will not be afraid. What has anyone to do to me? Remember your leaders, those who spoke the word of God to you. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Through him, then, let us continually offer a sacrifice of praise to God. That is the fruit of lips that confess his name. Do not neglect to do good and to share what you have, for such sacrifices are pleasing to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I invite you to stand for our sequence hymn 376.
Thank you. Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory to you, Lord Christ. On one occasion, when Jesus was going to the house of a leader of the Pharisees to eat a meal on the Sabbath, they were watching him closely. When he noticed how the guests chose the places of honor, he told them a parable. When you are invited by someone to a wedding banquet, do not sit down at the place of honor, in case someone more distinguished than you has been invited by your host. And the host who invited both of you may come and say to you, "Give this person your place." And then in disgrace, you would start to take the lowest place. But when you are invited, go and sit down at the lowest place, so that when your host comes, he may say to you, "Friend, move up higher." Then you will be honored in the presence of all who sit at the table with you. For all who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. And he also said to the one who invited him, "When you give a luncheon or a dinner, do not invite your friends or your brothers or your relatives or rich neighbors, in case they might invite you in return and you would be repaid. But when you give a banquet, invite the poor, the crippled, the lame, and the blind, and you will be blessed because they cannot repay you, for you will be repaid at the resurrection of the righteous." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
We gather in love. Love of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. So, how do you feel when you're sitting at a typewriter, for those of us who remember typewriters, at a computer screen, and someone is watching over your shoulder? Now, I don't know about you, but that's when I start, you know, tripling the number of mistakes I make. It just makes me nervous. There's actually psychological studies about all that. I won't go into it, but it makes other people nervous too. So, why are they watching? Now, typically, there's two reasons. One is they're waiting to watch and see and catch a mistake. Sometimes, though, people are standing there and they're watching because they are interested in what's going on. What's writing? How is this coming out? What is this going to look like? And so there's some interests in there. And so today, with today's gospel, what really caught my attention. Now, I don't want to say that there aren't lots of good lessons in this gospel. But what really got my attention today were the fact that Jesus was being watched. He was with the Pharisees, and they were watching him closely. Now, my guess is they might be interested in seeing how this is going to come out, but the reality is they were trying to catch him, something that they could use against him, because they are plotting against him already. But there's a twist to this, as there often is with Jesus. He's watching also. But notice that he's not watching the Pharisees. He's watching everybody. He's just noticing what people are doing. And I think he finds interest in that. And then he goes on to give some very wise and sage advice about some etiquette in order to help people avoid some shame and embarrassment. But I started thinking about Jesus watching and God watching. And God does. God watches us all the time. Not really not to judge us, not to find us doing something wrong. God watches us out of interest and out of care and out of love. And, you know, I was thinking about the story of Hagar. About 3 weeks ago, we were talking about Abram, who becomes Abraham, and how God took him outside and showed him the stars and said, this is going to be the number of your descendants, as many as the stars in the sky. And of course, he couldn't believe it. He and Sarah were quite old. She was barren. And with the promise of a child, Sarah and Abram get a little bit impatient waiting on God to fulfill this promise. And so Sarah gives Hagar her slave to Abram and says, okay, go ahead, have a child with her so that you have an heir. Well, of course, as soon as that happens, as you can only imagine, there's some tension in the room, and things get a little bit contentious. In fact, things get so contentious that Hagar runs away. Now, it's interesting. As you read that scripture in the Old Testament in Genesis, whenever Abram or Sarah talk about Hagar, they refer to her as their slave. To her, she's property. She's an Egyptian woman, their slave, their servant. But when Hagar runs away and she's out in the wilderness, God comes to her. And the first word is her name, Hagar. She's called by name. She's called by name because God sees her and what she's going through. She's called by name because God respects her. She's an individual person, his own creation. And God calls her by name because he loves her. And he also sends her back to Sarah and Abram. She doesn't want to go, but she goes back and following God's word. She has a son, Ishmael. But then later, Sarah, who becomes Sarah, has a son, Isaac. And then the tensions heat up a little bit more between the two women. And Sarah has had enough and says, Abraham, get rid of her. I can't handle it. Ishmael was picking on Isaac. Kids. But she had had it. And so Hagar once again finds herself out in the wilderness, and Abraham sent her out with a little food and a skin full of water. But the food is gone and the water is gone. And so Hagar sets her son over in the shade of a tree and gets away, backs up, so that she doesn't have to hear him crying. God comes again and speaks with Hagar. And things go well. They do not go back, but they go on. And Ishmael grows. And Hagar finds him a wife. And in the, Abraham from the Christian Judaism and Muslim tradition, goes all the way back. And in the Muslim tradition, Ishmael goes on to produce descendants from which the Islam tradition comes. But God saw her, and God loved her, and God acted out of that. And with what Jesus is teaching in this lesson, Jesus is watching and seeing. And out of respect and love and concern for the people, teaching. And as disciples of Christ, And in their example, we are called to do the same. You know, throughout the scripture, it talks about our hearts. Today, in our collect, it talked about our hearts. Graft in our hearts the love of your name. And how can we love God's name and not do God's will? Just notice throughout, all about love and what's in our hearts. We are called to see. We are called to see the people around us, those who are doing well and those who are in need. And we are called to love and respect them, because they are each individuals, God's own child, created in God's image, each with a name and a story and challenges and pains and fears, each also at time with joys and a sense of awe and wonder. And we are called to give and to provide and to help and assist. As Jesus taught today to those that he saw there at that Sabbath meal, he said, who are you to invite? You invite the lame, the crippled, the blind, the poor. We are called to do the same. But we can't do that if we don't see them. Now, I'm very, very happy this week. If you look out here over on Millington Street, our blessing box has been installed, and it has a few items in it. And I'll tell you, this week, the number of people coming, it's ever increasing, coming to our door. And all they need is enough to eat today, right now. And so this is a way that we can serve, through a blessing box, through something so small as a toothbrush, toothpaste, a can of soup. Now, that's not all we can do. That's not all we're called to do. But we see, we love, and we give. And as we depart from this holy place, may we take the desire in our hearts to do as Christ not just taught us, but came and showed us how to do so. Amen. I invite you to stand as we recite the summary of our faith in the ancient words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Our prayers for the people are Form 3, and they're found on page 7 of your bulletin. Or if you're following our live stream service online, they're found on page 5 of your online bulletin. We pray for the Most Reverend Michael Curry, our presiding bishop, and for the Episcopal branch of the Jesus Movement. We pray for the Right Reverend Kathleen Bascom, our bishop in the Diocese of Kansas. In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for the Anglican Church of Aotearoa, New Zealand, and Polynesia. In the World Council of Churches cycle of prayer, we pray for the people of Cape Verde, the Gambia, Guinea, Guinea-Bissau, and Senegal. In the diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for young adult and campus ministries across the diocese, especially St. Anselm's Canterbury in Lawrence and St. Francis Canterbury in Manhattan. Father, we pray for your Holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. We pray for those who are ill or facing other challenges. Especially today, we lift Nan. Are there others?
John, Ashley and Pamela. Aiden.
We pray for those who have died. Are there those you wish to lift?
Mel. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls. And to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we will delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us greet one another in the name of our Lord. While we're up and about, why don't we wave if they can see us? I don't know how close up we are. God's peace to all those who are joining us via the internet. God's peace indeed. Okay. It's hard to kind of draw that to a close, but we do have coffee hour afterwards, so that can continue. So for announcements, as I said, we have the blessing box up, and we're still making a sign to go on it, and there will be an article in the paper about it so that people know that it's here. But please do spread the word, because we want it to be used, and there is so very, very much need. We have a set of shelves that we'll set up here in the parish hall. As you bring things to stock, it's a ministry for all of us to contribute, not just as a narthex ministry, but anytime. Set them on the blessing box shelves. Canned food, especially cans that have the pop tops, that's helpful. Canned foods, hygiene products, deodorant, shampoo, that type of thing. Feminine hygiene products. I was, in fact, coming in the other day, I had just gotten back from Walmart, and someone walked up to me and said, I need some money for some feminine hygiene products. And I just happened to have them in my bag right there, able to help. But there is a great need, and the need is growing. So that we may see. Well, if you want to, you can just put them in the box as you come in. Or if they're for later use, because the box is pretty full, put them on the shelves. We're here in the office 5 days a week, so we will be keeping it stocked. Okay?
Where are the shelves?
As of Monday, they'll be up here in Parish Hall. There'll be a set of black shelves, and we will mark them and identify them. Other questions about that? Diane? Yes.
It has a
yes.
What are you putting?
Okay, the money collected in the little box. Now, next week is Labor Day weekend. How about the second Sunday in September, bring those back? And we will bless those for the payment of the blessing box. We still got to pay for it. It's up, but we still got to pay the bill for the building and for the stocking and things. So please, thank you very much. And thank you for doing that. That's wonderful. There have been a few donations made towards the building of the box, of the blessing box. By all means, feel free. Feel welcomed. Feel invited to contribute. We appreciate that. Okay. Other announcements. Next Sunday, we will have attendance in the nursery. So said that starting the first Sunday in September, we have one hired, and we hope this week, because we got to have two, and I'm going on faith, we will have two attendants in the nursery. Coco has been wonderful with playing for us, and we missed you last week. I heard, I was gone also, but I heard, oh, how we missed the music. And so, but we are still looking for someone. She says she'll play as long as she needs us, but we are still looking for somebody to play either piano, keyboard, organ. So spread the word. Keep your ear to the ground. And I will let you look through here for the other announcements. Sunday school, we would love to get both Sunday school going for youth as well as adults. So please see me if you're interested in either participating as a student or perhaps in some leadership. Are there other announcements for the good of the order? Oh, next month, September, what is the Narthex Ministry? Do you remember off the top of your head? Nope. We'll announce it next month. Okay. Do we have any birthdays or anniversaries? Well, I know of one birthday. Today, in fact. Yes. And our birthday prayer is at the bottom of page 9. Together, let us pray. Together, let us pray for Judith and all those celebrating anniversaries and birthdays. O God, our times are in your hands. Look with favor, we pray, on your child as she begins another year. Grant that she may grow in wisdom and grace and strengthen her trust in your goodness all the days of her life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Yeah. Birthdays are wonderful. Yeah. Now let us turn our hearts and minds to the altar of God. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. invite you to stand for the doxology. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. In fulfillment of his true promise, the Holy Spirit came down from heaven, lighting upon the disciples to teach them and to lead them into all truth, uniting peoples of many tongues in the confession of one faith, and giving to your church the power to serve you as a royal priesthood and to preach the gospel to all the nations. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore,
okay.
Let us keep the peace.
Alleluia. The gifts of God for the people of God. This is Christ's table. To this table all are invited in openness and forgiveness, in respect and with dignity, in harmony and in healing. Come because you seek Christ in the strength of his love and sacrifice. Come because you are loved.
Thank you.
Continuing with our post-communion prayer of thanksgiving, let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you. His light shine through you to those around you and remain with you always. Amen. I invite you to stand for our recessional, and the music is in your bulletin.
Thank you.
Let us go forth in love to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.